lot of smartasses texting me, asking me if those sixth graders were hot enough for me. I like hot kids on TV, all right? If you want me to watch a show like Stranger Things with a bunch of kids in it, I'm just saying, like anybody else on television, they better be attractive.
Did you see that?
There are a lot more options for eyeballs these days, and if you want mine, I'm not looking for hot kids in real life.
Did you see the kid from Stranger Things getting Matazaro? He has a prank show.
The Manger Tings kid?
Yeah. he's got a prank show on Netflix.
Well, yeah, we were talking about that a while ago.
Oh,
because
were we?
Yeah, we were people getting pissed because it's a prank show where you pretend somebody got a job. Remember? People were mad because they were like, this is a prank show.
Maybe it was one of the days I was out.
Well, I don't think so. Uh-huh. Maybe. But it's a prank show where he fools somebody into thinking they got a job.
That's right. Okay, yeah, I do remember.
And we're like, that's not cool.
No, that's fine. That is a dick move.
I think so.
Hey, you got a job. Oh, great. I needed this job. Ha! Just kidding. Not a real job.
Nope. Go back home. Mm-hmm. Sit there in the middle of the day. You don't have anything.
You have nothing.
Another chance for you to get yourself $1,000. Job or no job, you could get a grand here in about 6 minutes, closer to 2:30, and 30 past every hour on the show today. Our friend comedian Curtis Cook is going to join us around 3:20 as well. He is back in town to do a couple. Is he doing a couple of shows?
Doing two shows tonight at the Kennedy Theater for the Cleveland Comedy Festival.
So we'll talk to him a little bit later on.
Yep.
Alan, I'd like an intelligent take of yours on the whole Myles Garrett situation. I don't know that there is an intelligent take on the Myles Garrett situation, and I don't think if there was one that you would get it from me. Browns win last night. OBJ says it feels like they lost. You can understand where he's coming from. Yeah, I didn't really. All I watched was the helmet swing.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know what precipitated it. I didn't. This was at the end of the game.
At the end of the game. There's like 8 seconds left. He tackles Mason Rudolph after he throws the ball, so he falls on him, and then they're kind of scrapping with each other, both grabbing each other's helmet, and Mason Rudolph. It looks like he kind of gives him a little nut tap too.
Mm.
So that gets Myles Garrett all fired up. He actually rips the helmet off, and then Rudolph comes back at him after they've already been separated, and that's when he swings the helmet down and hits him on the head.
All I'll say is, you wanted a rivalry. Now that's a rivalry. People are like, oh, you know, I grew up, our rivalry was Bears-Packers. Brett Favre never took his helmet off and swung at somebody's bare head. This is a rivalry. You wanted one, right? You got one. Quit your whining.
There's a flag as, whoa, Mason Rudolph got
Rudolph
into
needs
it.
To get out of there.
Believe Myles Garrett, they're swinging
some,
a helmet?
Yeah, there'll be some ejections.
Well, he tackled Rudolph. Rudolph didn't like the way that he was tackled.
Oh, man. Rips the helmet off Rudolph's head and then eventually swings it and hits him in the head. And then Ogunjobi comes up and hits Rudolph from behind.
Beyond words,
oh,
Joe.
God.
That's a great name, too. Larry Ogunjobi.
Very good name.
Great name. And so a lot of people are calling...
Stupid move.
A lot of people are saying that the people calling out Myles Garrett are hypocrites.
Why is that?
I think it's a pretty lame argument. They're like, well, football's full of violence. You only want it a certain way. Like, yeah, you know how baseball is cool with using bats on balls but not on other players' heads? Yeah, it's kind of like that. Yeah, there are rules. It is a violent game, football, yes.
And this is a...
And there are rules. And
this was a violent action that didn't need to happen. It's very costly to the Browns. So even if you're a Browns fan and go, yeah, take that, Steelers guy, it still sucks because now we're without one of our best players for the rest of the season because he made a stupid decision at the end of a game that was already in the bag. He should have walked away. Mason Rudolph had a terrible game, so he was frustrated. That's why he's doing what he's doing. And then you take that bait and end up getting in more trouble because you get into this scrum with this guy that's trying to make you come at him. He's trying to get you to do something stupid because then you get in more trouble than him because they always get the second guy.
And of all the games...
And now you're out for the rest of the season, Myles Garrett.
But also,
it's a dumb move.
Of all the games, to have something overshadow the fact that the Browns really cleaned the Steelers' clock.
Yeah, yeah. We were in control
of
that whole game. Yeah.
I was doing my cocks out downtown last night, and thank you to everybody who came out. A lot of Steeler fans in town.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of Steeler fans who live here, but Steeler fans travel, too. It's not that far. If Buffalo fans come, you bet your ass Steeler fans are going to come.
Yeah.
And I don't think any Steeler fan thinks they're going to lose to the Browns. But they did.
Why would they?
In a big way.
They haven't lost in a long time, and then they lost yesterday, and it should be a great day, but it's a crappy day because we lost one of our best players for the rest of the season.
It's weird.
Yeah. And for people that are, like, proud of that, it baffles me. It really makes me
proud of him swinging the helmet.
Yeah, they're happy about that whole thing, and it's real gross to me. I don't get it.
Well, I'll tell you, if you are looking for an intelligent hot take, you need go no further than one Orenthal James Simpson.
Let's hear it,
because he's out there on the Twitter talking to people.
All I know is this: the minute Mason went after the man's helmet with his foot in his groin, it's on. I'm hearing all these announcers saying that Garrett should be suspended. Maybe he should. But when a guy's trying to get your helmet off your head, and that's where it started, with his foot in your groin, it's on.
I'll tell you what. I like how OJ wears his ring in all these videos. He didn't win a Super Bowl, did he?
He won a national championship.
There you go. He never won a Super Bowl. Whatever ring he's got, he wears it in every one of these videos. Mm-hmm. Big old fat ring. Hey, Rick.
Hey, Mr. Allen.
What's going on, Rick?
How you doing, Mr. Allen?
I'm fantastic.
That game was insane with the Browns and Pittsburgh, wasn't it?
Insane in the end game.
Well, we both know, all of us know, Pittsburgh is our number one rival, and then Cincinnati, right?
I would say Baltimore is higher on that list than Cincinnati.
Do you think so, Bill?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, well, we whooped Pittsburgh, and they couldn't handle it because they used to beating the Browns.
You think that's what it is?
Yes, definitely.
All right.
But every town has an era, right, Bill?
Yep.
Every town has an era.
Right. Once upon a time, it was Green Bay. Once upon a time, it was Dallas Cowboys.
That's right.
Okay.
That is right.
Now, this was the Browns. They can be a better team, Bill and Mr. Cox. We need to still work on our defense. Definitely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. By the way, Mr. Cox is my dad, Rick. You can certainly refer to me. As though we're friends.
Well, I want to put a handle on it.
I understand. You want to keep it professional. Mm-hmm. I appreciate that about you.
Okay. It's about respect.
Well.
Well, anyway. Yeah, the Browns, we need to work on our defense a little more. And our offense, too. But it's defense that wins the game. Everybody knows that.
Mm-hmm. Everybody knows that, Rick. No one could have said it better than you, all right? Everybody does know that.
I wonder how Rick's breakfast manners are.
How are your breakfast manners, Rick?
Yeah. Wait. When did the Cavaliers, play the same night or they played tonight?
No, they played last night.
They played last night against the Heat, and they got trounced.
They lost to the Miami Heat.
They ended up coming back and getting within 10, but Miami was in control the whole game.
How are your breakfast manners, Rick?
My breakfast manners?
Yeah, of course, exactly. No elbows on the table, right? No OJ in the fist?
No.
Good. That's what I like to hear.
Yeah, don't fist the OJ.
My corners of my mouth wet, dry. You know what I'm saying?
I know exactly what you're saying.
What spoon going what side, what fork going what side, what knife we're going.
That's right. You know where the little fork and the big salad fork and the entree fork. Nah, you got even got the pickle fork in there. I understand.
I really wish we could have had Rick there for those kids today. What's up?
I know what spoon is used for.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm. We're going to have dinner sometime, Rick, and you're going to prove that to me.
If you would like to.
Yeah.
You think I'm playing?
I'll tell you what.
Stay on the line.
What?
We're going to have a couple of 48-ounce porterhouses and wash them down with some Drambuie.
Let me tell you something, Mr. Allen.
Yeah.
We can do this.
Yeah. We'll figure it out, okay, Rick?
Yes, sir. good.
All right. Well, and I think we already got Rick's information.
Did we?
So, yeah, I grabbed it.
Okay.
All right. All right. Thank you, Rick.
I'm out.
All right. There is Rick. He is number 116 on the blacklist. He's an early adopter. And, boy, always exciting when we try to decipher. Hey, I have $1,000 here for you. It's a chance for you to go fund yourself. You get one of these every hour, so make it count. Good luck.
Hey, it's Rover. Go fund yourself. We have your shot at $1,000 now. Text the nationwide keyword PAN to the number 200-200. You'll get a text confirming entry plus iHeartRadio info. Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest. That's PAN to 200-200. Good luck and go fund yourself from 100.7 WMMS.
That's inexcusable. I don't care, rivalry or not, we can't do that. That's kind of the history of, you know, what's been going on here lately, hurting yourself, and that's just endangering the other team. That's inexcusable. He knows that. I hope he does now. The reality is he's going to get suspended. We don't know how long, and that hurts our team. And we can't do that. We can't continue to hurt this team.
I'll tell you what, I blame Baker Mayfield, because him walking around with that porn stash, I think that has sent a signal to the rest of the team that everything's loosey-goosey, like in the San Fernando Valley in the 70s.
Gotcha.
I think that he has sent some mixed messages with that love brush under there.
Like in curb stop someone with roller skates on.
There you go.
Yeah. Like.
Absolutely correct.
Right. People are upset that Mason Rudolph didn't get suspended. And I think that's by design, because I think the worst thing you can do to the Steelers right now is make him your quarterback.
But you want to keep him in there.
Oh, yeah. We'll play them again in 2 weeks.
I was going to say,
four interceptions.
Who's the third string guy?
I don't even know.
Who's the guy behind him?
I think somebody they picked up from Jacksonville.
All right.
That's also like a newer player. But, yeah, I want Mason Rudolph quarterbacking that team because he stinks.
Wow.
So
he's
let
really
that happen.
Cute, though.
Well, he's from Tennessee or something, in North Carolina, or he's some hill rod. So
him and his brother can get it.
All right, well, there you go. Mason Rudolph.
He is a douche, though.
I love
a
douche.
He's such a douche.
That's my fave.
Why is that your favorite?
I don't know. I'm attracted to people that are always the worst people, but yeah.
Maybe you see a little bit of yourself in them.
Yeah, like probably.
It. Yeah.
Probably.
But you're not a douche. You're a lot of things. You're not a douche.
But you said a little bit of myself, a little douche.
No, I mean like
a douche in me.
I don't mean douche is just one way to be like a garbage person. There are other ways to be that way, you know what I mean?
I guess.
Yeah, you can be a garbage person
in
so many different ways.
I've always felt really rejected by douchebags, so when I can get them, I'm like, oh, this is what it feels like to be on the other side. And I don't know, I feel like I've earned it.
So you...
I don't know why.
You're bummed out that you're rejected by... I would think that'd be a badge of honor if you were rejected by douchebags.
In the past, I've been rejected by douchebags. Like, no, you can't sit with us, or no, I'm not a fag, or blah, blah, blah. But then when douches are, like, befriending me, I'm like, oh, this is kind of nice to not have my head shoved in a toilet for once. Like,
wow.
I don't know. I don't know how to explain it, but that's my mindset.
You want to be included in your persecutor's kind of...
Yes.
Wow. I never wanted that. I never wanted to be.
If you can't
beat them, join them.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Boy, I never bought into that. I was never dying for the approval of the people who were beating me up.
I'm not dying for their approval. I think it's almost like a medal of honor. Once I like break down their walls and I actually get to do them, then they can't do anything to me anymore.
Break down their walls.
Yeah, because they have a facade, and then once I, corrupt that, they have nothing against me anymore. They can't ever call me a name or shove my head in the toilet.
Yeah, they can. They can still do whatever they want to do.
Yeah, but then I know deep down what goes down.
Wow, okay. Listen. I understand. You're living your life. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just, By the way, the Cocks out last night at the Ivy. It was nuts to butts.
I believe it.
Took me an hour to get down there from here. After the show. Yeah, because it was Cavs and Steelers.
Oh,
and,
my God. I didn't think an hour. Yeah,
it was crazy to get downtown.
And a trip.
More than a couple of people were like, hey, Bill get his keys? They wanted to know.
Yeah.
Did you get your keys today?
I signed the title today, and then I get the keys after work.
Oh, okay, but you get them today.
I get them today, yeah.
All right.
Yep.
We all have things to be proud of today.
That. And then also today is the tickets for Bill Squire's Chris McQuanzica go on sale. They're on sale now.
Uh-huh.
And I did just buy a condo, and I got to fill that thing up with furniture and stuff. So buy those tickets. It's also going to be a great show. But, also buy those tickets.
Can people donate furniture instead of buying a ticket?
No, I already bought all the furniture.
All right.
Yeah, I've been saving up. I'm fine.
I understand.
Really.
Okay.
But, you know, it's nice to have a little nest egg.
I bought my plane tickets to San Diego for our break. So I'm excited for that.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
How did you go from yesterday on the show saying, I hope I can make it happen, to the same day buying your tickets?
I bought them this morning, so it wasn't
the same next day saying, yeah, okay.
It was, because I told you, it wasn't a money thing. It was working out, you know, I don't have to worry about this job, but, you know, my other job coordinating with that.
I guess I thought it was a money thing.
It wasn't a money thing. I'm very frugal, so I didn't want to spend too much, and I had Christmas coming up, and I had other things I had to pay for.
What the tickets cost you?
I got out of a round trip for $400. It wasn't bad.
Oh, that's awesome.
Absolutely. We got a Christmas deal. I mean, not a Christmas deal, but like
Christmas deal.
A Christmas steal because, I mean, we're coming back Christmas Eve, and it's going to be very busy. So,
oh, that's going to be a nightmare.
I know.
Coming back Christmas Eve.
Christmas Eve.
That's how you got such cheap fares?
I don't know if that's why,
I bet it is, because nobody wants to travel on Christmas Eve.
But I don't have anything else to do for, like, the next
On Christmas Eve? You're not going to hang out with your family?
But my whole family's in the medical field, so sometimes we don't even celebrate Christmas on Christmas Day.
Oh, I see.
So we might have it, the weekend after or something like that. So, I mean, if it does, you know, spill over into Christmas, so what? Like, I get you your gifts beforehand, and I'll send my regards when I see you.
I hate all the running around for the holidays. I really do. And
me
I've
too.
Only
That's
I've only had it
early.
I've only had it as an adult because we did not have my dad's family around growing up. So we only had my grandmother, my mom's mom. We weren't making 19 trips to see people every year. For any holiday, we went to my grandmother's house. So it's like, you know, when sometimes if my mom gets a little upset with me because I don't make it home or whatever, I'm like, Mom, you never had to navigate different family holidays in different locations. We went to grandma's all the time, right? Mm-hmm. As an adult, got like in-laws and my older kids and other families. And I'm like, oh my God, they're running around. The one year that 2012, we got engaged. I think it was 2012. yeah, we did because we got married the next year. Yeah, 2012. Yes. Christmas 2012 is when we blew every. We went to Paris for Christmas and blew everybody off because we was just us still. It was fantastic, but you can't do that every year, you know. Mm-hmm. And it's
Especially
not like I don't. It's not like I don't
chase
like
around Paris.
Well, right. It's not like I don't like seeing everyone, but Jesus, it's just such a slog.
Well, I told everybody they are getting, and I shouldn't even say that. Like. You are getting one gift. Like, it's better not be over $100. Like, I have gone above and beyond for everybody all year. Nope. One gift. If you don't like
it. But you're going to need money to do things while you're in San Diego, too.
I have money to do things while
I'm
in San Diego.
How long are you going to be there?
Like a week. Mm. So we leave the 17th, so the day after our last show of the year.
Mm-hmm.
17th, and then come back the 24th.
Who's we?
My friend Kat and I.
Oh, okay.
That'll be fun.
I don't like traveling by myself. I get anxiety. I feel like people are about to kill
me.
But
she's like best friends with those guys too. So.
She is. Yeah. And she
Did you say
me.
You feel like your people are going to kill you?
Yes.
When you travel by yourself?
Absolutely. Because I don't travel that often, and especially by myself. So when I do travel by myself, I'm looking at my phone, making sure I'm in the right terminal. I'm itching and scratching because I'm like, like I'm going to get lost. Or like my plane's going to take off without me.
But just think of all the times here at work he's escaped death, Bill.
Oh, yeah.
I just grazed you. Shut up. I'm going to wound him before his holiday break. All right, I got Journey and Pretenders tickets for you. They're already set in next summer's tours. Both those bands are going to be on the road and hitting Blossom in June. I think it's the 30th. So if you want to see either of those bands, I'll get you set up shortly. 35192. Send me a text there or hit us up at alancoxshow.com.
The Alan Cox Show on 100.7 WMMS. And every